Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for the introduction and to invite me to this conference. I will talk about polygonal and polyhedral mesh refinement. It is a joint work with Professor Perrone. I will introduce the framework in where we are. We want to perform under flow simulation using the discrete fraction network and discrete fraction and matrix models. The difference between the these two models it is that the DFN have a rock matrix that is impervious, and we can neglect this rock matrix. I want also to define another geometrical object that is called trace, and it is the intersection between exactly two fractures. In order to use a polygonal and polyhedral numerical methods, we need to generate a polyhedral or polygonal mesh. But in this case, we want to exploit the complex geometry of DFN and DFM in order to generate a quasi-minimal induced mesh. And then we want to handle this kind of elements that we create to use an adaptive approach to improve the reliability of the solutions. How can we generate a quasi-minimal mesh for DFN? With the given DFN, we compute the traces of the DFN, and then we compute the intersection between the set of the traces and the fractures in order to generate a convex polygonal mesh. In fact, we can see strange elements with also aligned edges and so on. The sorting of the set of the traces can generate different meshes. We have seen empirically that if we reorder by length this this set, we can reduce the number of the cells. We can see an examples applied to a realistic DFN with 1,000 fractures. How can generate instead a mesh for DFM? We consider block as a cube and the network of the fracture, and we compute the intersection between the plane generated by the fracture and the block. In this case, we divide the block into two sub-blocks with the first fracture, and then with the second fracture, we divide the two blocks in four sub-blocks. But now we have the faces of the 3D mesh isn't conforming to the mesh of the fracture. Then we collect all the faces that lie on the plane generated by the fracture, and we generate a partition of these faces that is conform to the fracture. This method, it has been used for a DFM with 200 fracture, and we can see here what is the elements that we have to manage if we want to use an adaptive approach. Here we can see a solution at plane zeta 0.5. This solution is it has been computed with a standard conforming virtual element method. But now we want to use an adaptive method because we have generated a quasi-minimal mesh for DFN and DFM. The algorithm to solve estimate mark according to the algorithm proposed by Stevenson and Refine. In this talk, I will focus above all on the refinement strategy for polygons and polyhedra. Then, how we can refine a polygon element? We compute the centroid and its in its tensor, and then we compute the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this tensor, and then we generate a refining direction orthogonal to the eigenvector corresponding to the smallest eigenvalue. what means. If we consider this pentagon, we compute the maximum and the minimum momentum, respectively, the yellow axis and the orange axis. And we build a line orthogonal to the minimum momentum. The refining direction, it is the green line. But in order to not generate small edges and points very close, we collapse the intersection points. In the first implementation, we have collapse relatively to the length of the edges. But in the next slide, we can see a collapse tolerance that depends on the quality of the cells that we are refining. This approach, it has been used for DFN, and I will suggest you to look at the intersection between the fractures. This kind of algorithm can be extended for polyhedra, but the difference is we have to refine with a plane orthogonal to the eigenvector corresponding to the smallest eigenvalue. What means? If we consider this bar, we have cut this bar with a plane orthogonal to the blue axis that have a smallest magnitude. And we can see how it is defined bar. The collapse tolerance for the 2D case, we don't want to generate small edges. In the 3D case, we don't want to generate small faces. But the algorithm is very tricky, but for now we have implemented a smoothing algorithm that recognizes how many points are near the refining plane. And we move slightly this refining plane. An example, if we have to refine the red cube, but we have already refined all the neighbor cells, we have to exploit these 4 points to refine the red cube. We have applied this kind of refinement strategy, a smoothing algorithm, to a cube mesh refined uniformly. And the fact that the cube has the momentum axis of the same magnitude, we see that each 3 steps we recover the cube mesh, that because the number of the cells and the number of the points are a perfect cube number. Then this refinement strategy, it has been applied to a convex general polyhedron. Now, the maximum momentum does not refine the triangle as the longest edge refined, the standard refinement for triangles. And now we want to define a new refinement strategy in order to collapse to longest edge if we are using a triangle mesh. We see that the longest edge refinement refines the triangle with a median. The median for the triangle passed through the barycenter that can coincide with the centroid if we are using convex polygons without aligned edges. And the longest edge of the triangle coincides with its longest diagonal. Then we implemented for the polygons the longest diagonal algorithm, generating a refining direction that passes through the middle point of the diagonal and the centroid. But in some cases, the centroid can coincide with the middle point of the diagonal. In that case, the refining direction passes through the centroid, but it is orthogonal to the longest diagonal. In order to reduce the way of to cut the edge, we refine the edge always or in the its middle point, or if we collapse in the two vertices. Yeah, we see that for the reference element, maximum momentum and the longest diagonal have the same behavior. But if we change the triangle, we see that it is a different behavior. And for the square, we divide the square in the two triangles. Here we see that the edges are always cut in its middle point. Now I define some parameter in order to define a collapse tolerance. If we consider the pentagon, we want to see if if they are longer than this quantity rho, in order to preserve the quality of the cell and not generate small edges. In this case, we see that the red and the green segments are smaller than rho, and then I modify the refined direction in order to maximize the length of the edge. But in this case, we can also generate an edge that is longer than the maximum, than capital H, that that is the longest edge of the element. But if we use the power of a polygonal method, we can insert an internal point in its center. In our numerical test, we add this internal point when the new edge, the blue edge, is greater than the long half longest edge. We have tested our refining strategies with the L-shaped domain. We have two starting mesh, one triangular and the other one's polygonal. This is the mesh after 50 steps, 20 steps, 25. Here we can see that both the algorithm keep the right rate of convergence. The estimator at convergence have the same behavior with adding the internal point and without adding the internal point. But now we can see the effectivity index, and we see that adding the internal point, we are closer to the one respect to not add the internal point. After that, we are also analyzing the quality of the mesh. We have defined this parameter gamma, eta, R, R, H, that give us some idea of the quality of the mesh. And we see that if we analyze eta, that represent the ratio between the shortest and the longest H, we are bounded away from zero. Then this means that H, it is not so larger than the shortest H. And also for the gamma, that is the ratio between the diameter of the inscribed circumference and the longest edge. And also in this case, with internal point and without internal point, we are away from zero. Instead, for the aspect ratio in H, we see that the adding and without adding the internal point, the values are quite similar and are bounded from above. And also for aspect ratio in air. But we have also another graph that that means if we consider the maximum value of a aspect ratio in R, corresponding to the small value of the estimator. Then that cell does not affect in the refinement in the adaptive method. Future work. We want to complete the analysis of the quality of the mesh and try to improve the quality. And then we want to develop an algorithm for the polyhedron refinement in order to avoid the creation of the small faces. And then develop also a refinement strategy for non-convex polytops. Thank you for the attention.